So people probably wonder, oh, why are you supporting staying home in the quarantine? You know, has the American government ever told you anything ever, ever, ever that was I don't want to say conspiracy, but not a fucking subplot to fuck you over in some other way? And it's true, you know, they're exploiting the hell out of this situation. There's all kinds of shady business that I don't have all the answers to, but I can tell you this much. There is no good reason to go to work, ever. The fact that there may or may not be a virus is inconsequential. The fact is, you should not be waging. If you care about yourself, if you care about your family, care about any living human being or any living thing in general, you should never, never wagey. I can tell you after 5 years of waging that I wish I hadn't, and that I have never wanted so many people, well, not so many people, so few people in, you know, certain positions, third positions, to die. Fucking. Here's an example. Here's an example. When I was with one of my exes, one of my many exes, and she was a big turf, and she was a fucking liar and a cunt, and now she's a Nazi, apparently. Big surprise. You know, we were planning a life together, so that's when I got this wagey job. And, you know, I was going to go over there, and I was going to take care of her and things like that. So I get this wagey job, and I bust my ass. I'm working many more hours a week than I would want to for far less pay than I would want to. But I knew that going in. I knew going in that you're not going to get paid what you want. You're not going to work the hours you want. It's work. It's going to be hard. But there's a difference between working as in chopping woodwork and work as in they want to crush every morsel of hope that you have work. And I was doing security for a Walmart at the time, so you can imagine which one that was. And it wasn't enough that I did what I was told, which, by the way, I didn't have to because you're not my fucking boss. My only boss is the company that doesn't give half a shit enough to train me and tell me what I'm supposed to do. So I'm having to basically guess. And, you know, so they're giving me all these contradictory commands that I'm trying to follow to the best of my ability because, you know, like I said, I had hope. And I'm thinking, oh, I'm gonna make this new life with this girl and things like that. And because of all the people I'm surrounded by day in and day out, sometimes drug addicts, sometimes homeless people, which, by the way, Walmart to this day is still so retarded, they don't understand the concept that homeless people are like cats. There's good ones and there's bad ones. You keep the good ones around, keeps the bad ones away. You know, the good ones mark their territory, the bad ones stay away. If you let the bad ones in, the bad ones are gonna pee everywhere and break everything. Maybe that's the way it should be. But the point is that they discriminate against the good ones, not understanding that they have a valuable, you know, place there. Anyway, so, you know, I'm busting my ass harder and harder and harder. And then, of course, she breaks up with me because some retard thought it was a good idea to give women consent to anything. So, of course, now my life has no meaning. And so I'm still working because I wake up one day and realize, holy shit, I still have a job to go to even though I have no reason to go anymore. Well, that's fucking stupid. Anyway, so I'm going to the job and I also have immense strep throat, you know, from being around all these fucking drug addicts and shit, so I'm sick. And I'm just sitting there wallowing in my own pain and suffering, feeling like I'm dying both inside and out. And this fucking supervisor cunt comes up to me and is like, I'm calling your manager because I'm a black Karen and I'm stupid and I wasn't happy with something you did or didn't do. I don't fucking care. Go away. I don't care how sick I am. I will stick my boot up your ass. Get the hell out of here, Negress. And so that was the end of that. I got transferred. And that was what? 1 year? That was 1 year. And it looks like I described one of the centers of Dante's Inferno. You know, so imagine 5 years of that shit. Ugh. I'm not going back to that. I'm never going back to that. You should not go back to that. I don't care if you end up fucking homeless. Anything is better than that. Anything in this world is better than waging. The only thing worse than the day-to-day grind of being a wagey is moderators, and we all know how I feel about moderators. Ain't nothing comparing to that. So, that's it.